I am Joanna, an Ibaloy woman and a survivor of martial law. We are here at Marcos Park and Bus to remember the horrors of martial law and to say never again no to another Marcos in Malacañang. During martial law, this land was grabbed from the people of Taloy Sur to make way for that bus, and this whole area was developed as a park. That was not the only thing. Around 30,000 people were illegally detained, tortured, illegally arrested, and spent years in the prisons. Around 3,000 were extrajudicially killed. The wealth of the nation was plundered, and Marcos left the country with $27 billion in debt. Napakawalang hiya itong Bongbong Marcos. He refuses to apologize for the sins not only of his father but of his whole family. That was a conjugal dictatorship, and he was actually part of the Marcos family that was the dictatorship. Ngayon, he denies what his father did. He is benefiting from all of their ill-gotten wealth. Kasi yun naman ang ginagamit niya sa pangangampan niya ngayon. Yung nakaw na yaman mula sa mamamayang Pilipino. Kaya, wag nating iboto si Bongbong Marcos. All of us freedom and democracy loving people in Northern Luzon should look back, remember the horrors of martial law, and say never again to martial law, no to Bongbong Marcos. Mamamayan ng Baguio, Cordillera, Ilocos, Cagayan, ipakita natin sa mga Pilipino na hindi totoo ang solid north.
Never again, never again, never again to martial